In today's video, we're going to show you how to paint the armour of the Bloodied Dawn Stormhost. First of all, you'll need to undercoat the model. As you can see here, I've used Chaos Black. This is a great starting point for all those moody colours we'll be painting them. So for the actual colours themselves, we'll be painting the armour using Incubi Darkness. We'll then pick out the shoulder pads, tabard and shield using Screamer Pink. Then all the metallics we'll use Lead Belcher. Then for some shades, we'll shade over all the armour and the magentas using Norn Oil. And the actual metallics themselves, we'll shade with Coelia Green Shade. Then we'll do some highlighting, starting with Sotek Green on the armour, Pink Horror on the shoulder pads, or the magentas. Then we'll use Stormhost Silver on all the metallics. So starting with that Incubi Darkness, I'm going to use a medium base brush. So I'm just going to apply a load of that to my palette. And I'll thin it down as well. Because obviously we'll just need to do a couple of thin coats of this just to get some nice coverage on that armour. So once you're happy about much is on your brush, we'll start applying it. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to quite liberally slap it on. We'll do a couple of coats here because this is the first colour, we don't have to be too neat. With the model now base coated, we're going to use Screamer Pink and we're going to pick out the shield, shoulder pads and tabard. And again, you want to do a couple of thin coats with this, and I'm using a medium layer brush. With the Screamer Pink now dry, we're going to apply Lead Belcher to all the metallic areas. For this, we'll be concentrating on areas like the trim, around the shoulder pads, on his helmet, his hammer. We've also got the sigil on the front of the shield as well. And some other little details like belt buckles and the chainmail at the bottom there. So just take your time with this, and I've gone for a medium layer brush. Keeping with the medium layer brush, I'm now going to start applying Norn Oil to all the magenta areas and the Incubi Darkness, paying special attention not to get it onto any of the metallic areas. Just take your time when you're getting around these areas. After leaving plenty of time for Norn Oil to dry, we're just going to use Coelia Green Shade on all the metallics. And again, just be neat, try not to get it on the other areas. And again, I'm using a medium layer brush for this. With all those shades now applied and dry, we're going to begin highlighting. We'll start with the armour. This will be using a small layer brush, and we're just going to be getting Sotek Green on all those raised areas. Just take your time here and don't rush. With those blue areas now highlighted, we're going to begin highlighting all the magenta areas using Pink Horror. And I'm still using my small layer brush. Around the shield, I'm just going to use the edge of the brush. You can do that on the shoulder pads, but when we get to the tabard, we'll just have to use a tip and be very careful. Just make sure you highlight all those areas. And finally, we're going to highlight all those metallics. And for this, I'm using Stormhost Silver and a small layer brush. Now, as before, just use the edge of the brush where needed. There's also a couple of rivets on these bits of tabard here, so I'm just going to stab those with a little bit of Stormhost, just to emphasize those rivets. Everywhere else, just take your time. And there we are. The armor of the Bloodied Dawn Stormhost is done. All that's really left to do is a few details like the parchment and the sword. So I hope you found that useful. Keep sending those requests in and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.